There he is. What's up, buddy?
What's up?
What are we doing today?
Back.
Why don't you tell us what you're doing?
You know, I'm prepping for the Arnold. My man's Dave gonna get this nice workout with me.
Yeah?
Because he's a little fella.
That's right.
To get with the big fellas.
All right, this is my buddy Anton. Today we're working on a powerhouse East Lansing. We're working on back and maybe a little bit of shoulders if he's into it. You know. Because he is working towards his first physique competition at the Arnold Classic. We're working on a powerhouse today. Let's get it.
Let's get it.
Back to another Cooking with Hannah Calves. Today we are making protein puppy chow, working a little bit more on intuitive eating rather than destroying ourselves with counting each little macro. So go ahead and find yourself protein powder, get some Rice Chex cereal, some chocolate peanut butter, some powdered sugar, two bowls, and a scale. Also make sure you have a helper for today. As mentioned, we're focusing a little bit more on intuitive eating, kind of a healthier snack, being aware of what we were putting into our body rather than trying to destroy ourselves counting every little number, every little nutrient that goes into our food. Here is the breakdown for our food today. About 300 calories total, 12 grams of fat, 43 carbs, and 10 grams of protein. It is puppy chow, again, so these might not be the ideal carbs if you're trying to get skinny for spring break, but oh well. Go ahead, pause the video really quick and take a look at the serving sizes for each item that will go into the protein powder today, and then let's get into it. I've got sunshine in my pocket. I'm just right here in my zone. I've got Sade in my tape deck. I'm just moving right along. All these haters really love me. They just pretend that they don't.
Life a long kiss goodnight. This dream difficult for me to visualize, but I was real when they said the limit is the sky. But my feet set on solid ground. No more stalling now. On the road to get it, cause when it rained it poured, but now the storm finally calming down. I'm from a cut that's driving, the sun is shining. But strain piece studded with a ton of diamonds. I ain't got a bunch of money on a constant grind. Still at peace being blunted with my stomach growling. In the dark asylum, got the heart to fight. I see the stars are bright, they screaming Johnny Valiant. Rappers on the bite me, they crocodiling. I'll be up and even mark a smiling. Try to walk a mile, I'm a JPEG, a Maybelline. You can say that you played in the major league. With my heart on my sleeve on the stage and leave, I feel wet from the sweat. I'm a famous tea. I'm never scared for sugar like a maple leaf. Cause what the ways for me is unknown. So a little of my J for my kiddo.
Hello, 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 and welcome back to another Food for Thought. This week we're going to be talking about the effects of alcohol on muscle growth per the recommendation of a number of my buddies. We are college students, so there are two things we like to do. We like to go to the gym all day long, and we like to go to the bar here and there. So this is definitely something that has crossed our mind from time to time. What people don't know is exactly what goes on in the body, and I'm going to be talking about today, along with maybe some other tips and tricks to mitigate some of the effects of alcohol on muscle growth. So one of the first things that happens with alcohol in the presence of the body is testosterone is affected. For the sake of things, I have a biological definition as well as a results-related definition, more so explaining the effects on muscle growth. There are obviously a lot of benefits to testosterone in the body, which play a part in recovery and strength gains. And for the sake of things, I'm not talking about artificial testosterone, I'm talking about naturally occurring testosterone. As we all know, testosterone definitely plays a part in strength and muscle gains. It also plays a part in a number of other functional processes in the body. Low testosterone definitely calls for fatigue, muscle tone loss, and a number of other health concerns. Another effect that alcohol has in the body is protein synthesis is inhibited, which is probably the most counterproductive thing you can do if you're working out consistently. As mentioned above, protein synthesis is that repairing of micro tears in our muscles after resistance training. As mentioned, alcohol plays a very counterproductive part in the system of protein synthesis. It blocks process rather than allowing it to play its course during the recovery process. And in just a bit, we will be talking about possible ways to combat this issue. One of the last major effects that alcohol has on muscle growth is a lag in growth hormone. Growth hormone is secreted by the pituitary gland and is most present during periods of deep sleep. Simply put, alcohol plays a direct effect on the quality of our sleep, which then affects the quality of HGH secretion. Poor sleep calls for an inefficient secretion of HGH, and also is the reason for a number of other effects that we feel when we wake up the next day. We're now going to jump into not ways to eliminate effects of alcohol on muscle growth, but possibly combat some of the symptoms. Obviously, timing is huge. Not drinking on training days is efficient for that protein synthesis that we talked about earlier, where it is very counterproductive to drink while recovering. The next suggestion is supplemental. Using NAC, which is an antioxidant, in the presence of leucine, which is replenishing an amino acid that is severely depleted and wasted during alcohol, is another way to mitigate some of those effects. Essentially, we're providing the body with an antioxidant replenishment to fight off the harmful toxins, as well as muscle growth inhibitors, that decrease the effectiveness of taking in amino acids and the rebuilding process. Once again, these are just some recommendations from things that I dug up through my research. These are not going to stop the overall effects of alcohol. And also, First Form recently put out a product called Remedy. It's not promoting drinking, it just recognizes that we do from time to time have a drink. And it really helps to metabolize the alcohol, prevent hangovers, and supply the body with useful vitamins to get over that next day feel bad. And that was our Food for Thought this week. If you want me to research anything or go over anything in future videos to come, please email me. Do not hesitate. Thanks. All right, straight up, stop what you're doing right now. I know you're watching my vlog, obviously, which is awesome, but I want you to go to windywillowapparel.com. Check it out for a second if you haven't already. Then toggle to the blog tab. There, you'll see I have a number of blogs. I put them out every week, or try to. The most recent one is called Anger. I promise this one's one of the better blogs that I've put out, definitely straight from the heart. And furthermore, if you toggle back to the collection tab, this week I put out a promo code for all Halvorson Fitness viewers. That promo code is displayed on the screen right here. HalvyFit, 10% off anything you want in my collection, just for you guys. Thanks.